Ready to get inside the mind of your Nevo Smart Grill? Let's dig in. For the full Smart Grill experience, you'll want to connect Nevo to the Next Grill app. You can operate Nevo without the app, which we'll show you, but we're going to need to start with the app. So download the Next Grill app from the Apple or Google Store. Plug in your grill, turn it on, and then open the app. Make sure your Bluetooth is on in your phone settings. After you create an account, use the red plus sign in the app to connect to Nevo. You will connect through Bluetooth and then have the option to connect through Wi-Fi as well. If you choose to connect through Wi-Fi, you will be able to monitor and control your grill from anywhere with a connection. Once you make a Wi-Fi connection, the controller will always look for that connection first. If you need to operate using Bluetooth instead, you must go to your grill settings in the app to temporarily disable Wi-Fi function of the controller. You can't light your grill from the app for safety reasons, but you can do everything else, like monitor and adjust grill temperatures, timers, and target food temperatures on your probes, allowing you to kick back, relax, and enjoy the cookout. Now let's look at Nevo's SureTemp controller. Nevo smart grills come equipped with a NexFi-enabled SureTemp controller, a state-of-the-art LED control panel that operates on a finely tuned algorithm that can maintain even cooking temperatures for hours. That means no more fiddling with knobs to maintain your grill's internal temperature. Let's look at all the different buttons, functions, and modes on our controller. Here, we have power, which turns the grill on and off. Mode, which you use in combination with other buttons to light the grill and activate cooking modes. Zone A and Zone B to light the grill and control your cooking zone manually, if desired. Probes, P1 to P4 button, which allows you to view probe temps and set and track target internal temperatures. The timer button and self-clean mode. Temp controller is designed to automatically maintain the cooking temperatures that you set. It also has a few preset modes to make cooking and cleaning a little easier. Grill mode, the default mode for everyday grilling. This is where you'll operate Nevo most of the time. Warm mode, this keeps your food warm after it reaches your target temperature. Warm mode operates automatically off probe 1 or can be entered manually. Manual mode, to take over the controls when you don't want Nevo driving. Manual mode allows you to set a low or medium burner level and Nevo won't adjust your settings. A good time for manual mode would be grilling hot dogs and burgers with the lid open. Self-clean mode kicks Nevo to high and burns off your cook for 10 minutes before automatically shutting down. You'll still need to brush debris off the grates, so you're ready for your next cook. Bonus, you'll never leave your grill on all night by accident and run through your propane. To ignite both burners, press mode A, then mode B. We recommend to always light both burners. This will help your grill to reach your desired cooking temperature more efficiently. Nevo sets the target temperature to 450 when you first light it. Let's talk about temperature and how your burners adjust automatically. At target temps at or above 450, Nevo will have both burners lit always. If both burners are operating and a temperature less than 450 is entered, zone B will automatically turn off. This is by design to reach the lower temperatures. Make sure you place your food on the best side for cooking based on if you want direct or indirect heat. To reignite and keep burner B lit, set a target temperature above 450 and then press mode and burner B to light. Note, when grilling at temperatures less than 450, zone A is the only active burner. If you try to relight zone B, in most cases, it will relight, but will automatically shut off shortly afterwards as the temperature is set below 450. This is by design to reach the lower temperatures. Make sure you place your food on the best side for cooking based on if you want direct or indirect heat. Self-clean mode can only be started when both burners have been turned off. This ensures you have removed food and are ready to clean the grill. To turn off your burners, press and hold zone A and/or zone B for 3 seconds to shut down. To start self-clean mode, press mode and self-clean. It is best to start the self-clean mode after you've completed cooking each time. If you are starting self-clean mode before cooking, for best performance, preheat the grill to 450 before starting the self-clean mode process. To cancel self-clean mode, hold down the self-clean icon for about 3 seconds or press the power button. If you want to use the auto warm mode, position your food over zone B, connect a meat probe to the first port and set the target temperature either on the controller or on the app. Once your food reaches its target temperature, the auto warm mode activates, turning off zone B and automatically lowers the target temperature to 250 degrees until you're ready to plate. Meat probe port 1, called P1, is used for the auto warm mode. To prevent the grill from entering auto warm mode, either do not enter a target probe temperature or use one of the other ports. To exit warm mode, set a new target temperature with the grill dial. The grill is designed to preheat no matter the target temperature and takes about 15 minutes. This allows all the components to reach an even, stable temperature and improves cooking performance. If the lid is open for a long time, the loss of heat will result in the grill increasing the output to maintain the target temperature. Doing so could result in overheating or overcooking your food. After closing the lid, the temperature will fluctuate before realigning to the target temperature. If you must cook with the lid open, we recommend using manual mode to control the burner levels. If desired, you can manually set the burners to a low or medium setting by using manual mode. To manually control the heat output with one or both burners operating, press one of the burner icons, A or B. Then press mode to cycle from low to medium. Lights on the display will toggle between low and medium when you press the mode button. Pressing the red dial will confirm the choice and lock the values in this position. You might want to do this when grilling something simple, like a hot dog, or if you have a stubborn flare-up while grilling a juicy steak. By switching to a low setting, you can quickly reduce the heat, helping you to manage your cook. To switch warm or manual mode back to grill mode, simply change the temperature on the dial and press the dial to confirm. Probes. To set your desired probe temperature, press and cycle between your probes with the probe button. Once your desired probe is displayed, press and hold the probe button until the temperature function begins to flash. Set your desired probe temperature and press the red dial to confirm. To cancel your probe, cycle through to your desired probe and press and hold the probe button for about 3 seconds. To set a timer, press and release the timer button once. The minutes flashes first. Use the red dial to select minutes. Press the red dial to confirm the minutes. The hours are now flashing. Adjust the hours and press the red dial to confirm. After a few flashes, your timer is set. The HR and MN icons will flash while your timer is active. To cancel your timer, press and hold the timer button for about 3 seconds. On a rare occasion, your controller may display an error code. These codes are defined in the manual and in the app under More. Error codes are communication from the grill asking you to take an action to restore the grill's performance. If an error occurs, look up the reason code. Address the issue and then clear the code. You can clear the error code by disconnecting the power so the controller can initialize and restart. One common error is forgetting to open your propane tank valve. The grill will attempt automatic ignition 3 times before returning an error. If you notice the grill does not ignite once it has paused ignition, which is no sparking sound, be certain the gas cylinder is open. Here are some common errors that may occur. ERA and/or ERB might appear during ignition or operation. This occurs when no flame is detected and might result when grilling in windy conditions or during ignition if there is no gas flow. ERH might also occur in windy conditions. This would result if the wind is strong enough to blow too much heat from a burner directly onto the grill's internal probe. Position the grill to change how the wind is affecting the flames to improve performance. And just like that, you're a smart grilling expert. Because that's all there is to knowing your way around Nevo SureTemp controller. So how'd we do? Did this guide help you feel more in command of your Nevo Smart Grill? Let us know down in the comments section. And as always, for more tips and techniques, be sure to visit nextgrill.com or subscribe to our YouTube channel.